Well, hi everybody. Sorry for the silly glasses again, but they do keep the wind out of my eyes. Yeah, my 4 hours ride that I planned on commute, unfortunately I've not been able to do it for two reasons. The first reason, and perhaps the most valid, is that the Two Tunnels Greenway is closed. It's part of the route I wanted to cycle. The Devonshire Tunnel has been flooded, and apparently there's tree surgeon work going on, so that part of the route is closed at the moment. And also the paths and the tracks, single tracks etc, have been so waterlogged, it's not really been it's been a right mess on the paths and on the single tracks. Secondly is that I've done my backing. I had a bit of dull backache after I was doing some work on my motorcycle. I was bent over for quite a long period of time taking the back wheel out and doing a few adjustments to the bike, and I developed a bad back, which has led on to sciatica. But the good thing is it hasn't stopped me from cycling. In fact, when I cycle the back pain goes away and the sciatica goes away, so that's what I mean by not much of an excuse. Anyway, I've done something to my bike. I'll show you. I bought the frame bag that I mentioned I was going to buy. I'll show you that. I'll show you my new back bike packing setup at the moment, and I've got everything on this bike that I need for a single overnight or a multi-week adventure. Not that I'll ever get the time to do that, but certainly anything I need ongoing to stay on the bike for days and days at a time. Right, let's show you the bike. Well, here we are. Here's the bike, the On1 Bootzipper. Fantastic, I really enjoy this bike. That's the frame bag I bought. It's a 6-litre Ortleib. I'm using that mostly for food. I've got my little pump in the bottom there, but mostly food in there. I've got water on a rack there. I've got water on the fork there. Coming out to the front of the bike, I've got my tent. I've got my toolkit, navigation, lights, cameras, charging system. In the back here, this is a 35 litre Alpkit Gourdon, an old bag now, but everything I need in there for sleeping arrangements, spare clothes, toiletries, sleeping bag, pillow, thermarest mat, stove. That's it. And if anyone's interested, I did do a review of this saddle, the SMP saddle. I've also got on there, you can see it moving, the suspension seat post. This has been a game changer for me. Really, really comfortable. I get no sore backside, no discomfort from it at all, and it really does absorb the shocks. So that's the setup. The other thing is it's really light. The whole lot I can lift up, even with a dodgy back. I'll show you. Being a bit careful. So there you go, for keeping things light and simple, I think that's the best bet really. Anyway, cycle on now, get to camp. I'm going to meet up with a friend of mine, Shane. He's cooking me, he's doing some chefing tonight apparently. I'm not sure what he's doing, but he's going to cycle into the wood as well. So this is a permission woodland camp, but as I say, bit of a shakedown because we will be doing some serious bike packing in the not too distant future. The advantage of this setup is it's really light, it's very simple. That old an acronym, KISS, keep it simple stupid, is the philosophy behind this. Very few items of equipment being carried, very simple to pitch and put up the camp. That is very simple. and quick to take down, pack away and be on my way again. Got a bit of hiker bike going on because the ground's just too wet to cycle on, and it really has been such a wet winter. I don't think I've experienced a winter as wet as it has been. Anyway, not sure if Shane's here yet. I've only got a couple of hundred yards to hiker bike. Hiker bike means to push your bike, get off and push. So I don't know if Shane's here yet or not. Now Shane is he's a bit of a pagan. He likes his old beliefs, and each to his own. I've got nothing against that. Whether you're a Christian, a pagan, an atheist, a Muslim, a Shintoist, don't bother me. Just don't force any of your beliefs on me. I'll keep my beliefs to myself. But anyway, he's brought me a gift. He calls it a Yule gift. I think it was supposed to be a Christmas present, but I haven't seen him since Christmas time. So it's the first time I've met him this year. So he's brought my Yule gift for me. But what he doesn't know is that I've also got him. I got him a Yule gift as well. Yeah, here's the woods. Look. Yeah, very barren and windswept still, but spring is on its way. Hiya Shane, how are you?
It's a dream, mate,
you. Alright, yeah. Are you hammocking or are you on the ground?
Got me little bivvy thing.
You're on your bike? Is it an e-bike?
Yeah. Well, meant to be.
You never catch me riding one of them. So what sort of bike is it then?
It's a Career of Vengeance 2.
Oh, all right.
Pedal assist, it's not e-bike.
Well, yeah, you've got to put a bit of work in then.
Well, it's all right getting a bit a hill.
Yeah.
The battery life on it is no good.
Isn't it?
Bike build's really good, but the battery, like it said, between 15 and 20 miles. And I cycle to work, cycle back and cycle in, and that's about 9 miles and it's on 2 bars.
I've got brilliant battery life on this.
Leg power, yeah?
dropped a good one. Took about 5 minutes to set up.
1, 2, 3, 4. 8 pegs. 10 if you want to peg out the hoop, which I will because it's going to be quite windy. A very easy tent to set up and a brilliant bikepacking tent, I think. Terra Nova laser competition. This is the Mark 1. I've had it for years. Well, that's the tent all set up, very simple shelter, and I can tell you it's going to take me just a few minutes in the morning to strike it all down and be on my way, so that really to me is a big bonus. So what's that then? A secret ingredient, did you say?
Yeah, it's a Nor beef stock cube. Stock pot, but they're really good.
Nor?
Yeah.
You ate them, do you?
Oh yeah, they're really good.
Well, that's starting to cook nicely now. But Shane's got me a Yule gift. Now, I hadn't seen Shane for 5 or 6 months, and we were supposed to have a camp, weren't we? But it got postponed. So, he's bought me a Yule gift. I reckon it's a saw. I reckon it's a saw. Nice little saws, actually. Well, I guess. So basically, it's a saw that you I'll have to practice with it. It comes with two blades. You get a metal cutting blade and you get a wood blade. So a hacksaw and a wood saw. So that is it. It's basically it's a metal version of a buck saw. Weighs next to nothing and very compact. Cuts really well. So that's something else for the old bushcraft armoury. Thanks very much, Shane.
Sorry, mate.
So that was it, he gave me a nice Yule gift. So I got to give him something in return. Something homemade. Mine's just homemade, Shane. It's just homemade.
You shouldn't have. Is that one of your whittlers?
A whittler?
Hey!
It's a whittler because you're a whittler, mate.
Thanks, mate. That is lush. I take pride of place in my armoury.
You do a bit of whittling with that.
I'll whittle you some up with that, my yeah. First whittle.
That'd be nice.
Bread.
Oh, look at that, look. Ciabatta bread, we've got a nice hot stew, beef stew, sirloin beef, you say?
Yeah, sirloin.
Mm-hmm. me warmly ensconced within my lovely little tent. Just putting on some down booties just to keep my feet nice and warm. And then get my head down. Apparently it's going to rain. We're expecting rain in the next half hour. It's just gone about 20 past 10 now. So by 11 o'clock we should be having rain. And then it's going to be intermittent throughout the night. And a bit in the morning. So it'd be nice to lie in my tent, comfortable and warm in my sleeping bag, and fall asleep to the sound of rain pittering and the pattering on the tent. Right, let's get myself set up for the night. Good night. Comfortable night, a comfortable night. Anyway, let's face the cold light of dawn. Let's get this done. The worst part of camping, getting up. I could lie another half hour. So there he is, look. Morning, Shane. You didn't have a good night last night then? It was a bit cold, you said, a bit chilly.
Yeah, a little bit chilly. Yeah. I brought a lightweight tropical sleeping bag, didn't I?
Oh, yeah.
Just trying that out to see what it'd be like. But.
Yeah. Well, I was toasty warm. I was really warm, and I had my little down booties on. I could have laid in bed another half hour easy this morning.
I know, I was.
I didn't want to get up this morning.
No, I was awake about 4.
Yeah. Anyway, I'm almost packed up. I mean, it's all packed up here now. All I've got to do is drop the tent now, have a cup of coffee, maybe a bite to eat, and I'm off home. That's a good thing with ultralight. You know, you can set up quick and you can pack down and be on your way quick. Especially when you're bike packing, you're obviously many times in places you shouldn't be while camping and that, so you don't want to be lingering around in the mornings mostly. Obviously, it doesn't matter on this sort of camp, we're mission camp here.
Yeah.
Everything's so wet. I've never known a winter like it. I think this has been the wettest. We've got standing water over there, which is where we've got this special tree called the Wizard's Tree because it keeps producing beer. Anyway, I stocked up the Wizard's Tree with the cans we didn't drink last night, so they're there for another camp at some point in the future. I just got to make sure I get back before Shane does and I can enjoy them beers again. But I was just saying how wet it's been. What were we saying about the wet weather?
Hopefully it'll get
that was it. There's a saying about March, now we're now into April, there's a saying about March that March comes in like the lion and goes out like the lamb. So basically meaning that the beginning of March is very wintry and cold and bleak. And the end of March, generally it's beautiful and it's warm and the lambs are born. But this is April now and it's been bleak, hasn't it? Cold, wet. The woodland is still in the grip of winter.
Damn.